What does the color of your vaginal discharge actually mean? Is it normal or could it be a sign of an infection? As women, we've all noticed changes down there at some point in our lives. And let's be honest, it can feel confusing or a little bit scary. Now, the truth is, your discharge isn't just random. It's your body sending signals about your health. From clear discharge to gray, white, yellow, even green, I'm going to be explaining what each color means, when it's normal and when it's not, the infections or conditions behind them, how to reduce your risk of abnormal discharge, and when to see a doctor. I am Nurse Sandra, and on this channel, we'll talk about understanding your body, your health, and your fertility. If you're just coming across my video for the first time, please do not make it your last by clicking on the like and subscribe button. Also, turn on your notification bell so that when I upload a video, you'll be the first to get notified and watch the video. That being said, let's dive straight into the video. Let's start with yellowish discharge, not just slightly off-white, but distinctly yellow. This could mean an infection, and the biggest common concern is gonorrhea. Gonorrhea is a sexually transmitted infection, and the trickiest part about gonorrhea is that, according to the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, approximately half of women with gonorrhea are asymptomatic. That means you may not even know you have it. There will be no symptom. It will just mean your body spreading, and the worst part is, when it spreads, it doesn't just affect your cervix, that's the entrance of the womb. It can also affect the throat, the rectum, and even the eyes. Now, when symptoms shows up, you may notice yellow vaginal discharge, pelvic pain, painful urination, or even bleeding between period or after sexual intercourse. Treatment for gonorrhea is antibiotics, which will be prescribed to you by your doctor. But the most important thing is getting tested early, because untreated gonorrhea can lead to infertility. Now let's talk about vaginal discharge that looks yellowish green. This is often caused by trichomoniasis, another STI gotten through unprotected sexual intercourse. Here's the interesting thing. According to WHO, World Health Organization, 50% of women don't know they have it because they may not show symptoms. And for those that show symptoms, the symptoms may start to appear between 5 to 28 days after the infection. So the signs include greenish yellow frothy discharge, a very strong offensive odor, itching, sore around the lips of the vagina, or pain during urination or after sexual intercourse. The good news is it's treated with antibiotics like metronidazole, but that will be decided by your doctor, and you and your partner would have to undergo treatment to prevent reinfection. If you're finding this video helpful, please don't forget to like the video, subscribe if you haven't, and also share the video out so a lot of women out there will get to see the video and learn from it. Another vaginal discharge color we're going to be looking at is red or pink discharge. This simply means that blood is present. Sometimes it's completely normal, like when you have spotting before your period or when you have light bleeding after sex as a result of friction. It can also happen around ovulation or in early pregnancy, what is known as implantation bleeding. I have a video on my channel where I talked about how to differentiate implantation bleeding from period bleeding. Do want to watch that video so you learn more about it. Red or pink vaginal discharge can also be a warning sign if you notice it outside your period, when your period is not closed. And if it keeps happening, it may signal conditions like cervical infection, polyps, or even in rare cases, cancer, especially during menopause. It could be a sign of endometrial cancer. So while occasional light spotting may be normal, if you experience frequent or unexplained bleeding, please see your doctor. I have a video about period blood colors, what they mean, and what they say about your health. Make sure you watch that video after this one. Now, the fourth one we're going to be looking at is gray vaginal discharge. If you notice gray, thin, watery vaginal discharge with a fishy smell, that's most likely bacterial vaginosis. It is linked to an imbalance in vaginal bacteria when you do things like washing inside the vagina, using scented soap, or douching. These things can upset the natural pH of the vagina and allow harmful bacteria to grow. So women with BV would usually experience symptoms like fishy smell odor, which can be stronger after sexual intercourse, thin gray discharge, or sometimes irritation. Bacterial vaginosis itself isn't sexually transmitted, but it does increase your risk of catching STIs like HIV, gonorrhea, or chlamydia. Treatment is usually with oral or vaginal antibiotics, but the prevention is making sure to keep the vaginal pH intact. The fifth one is cream or white vaginal discharge. Cream or white discharge can be normal, especially if it's smooth, not too thick, has no itching or odor. But when it turns thick, clumpy or looks like cottage cheese, that's usually a yeast infection or what we call thrush. Thrush happens when the natural balance of good bacteria in your vagina is disturbed and the yeast overgrows. And this can sometimes happen after completing the course of antibiotics, which can kill the good bacteria in the vagina, or when your immunity is low. Now, symptoms may include itching, burning, redness, pain during sex, or that thick discharge that looks like cottage cheese. Interestingly, not all women get symptoms. It can go away on its own, but often it needs treatment with antifungal cream or oral tablets. The system we're going to be looking at is clear vaginal discharge. This is what most women usually see, and it's normal. It means your vagina is healthy, your pH is balanced, and there is no infection. The amount and consistency can change depending on where you are in your cycle. Sometimes it can be watery, sometimes it can stretch like egg white around ovulation, and sometimes you notice more when you're sexually aroused. This does not need any treatment unless it's suddenly associated with pain, itching, or bad smell. Now, how do you reduce your risk of abnormal vaginal discharge? The first thing is avoid douching or using scented soap, because it can disrupt the vaginal pH, which can predispose you to recurrent infection. 2. Practice safe sex. Use condom to reduce your risk of STI. 3. Always keep the vagina clean and dry, and ensure that you're washing the vulva area with plain water or unscented soap with water. 4. Make sure you complete any prescribed antibiotics properly. And the 5th and most important one is ensure you're getting regular STIs checked if you're sexually active. And also, if you have a new partner, make sure you get checked with your partner. Now, when should you see a doctor? If your discharge is green, yellow, or gray. If your discharge has strong fishy or foul smell associated with pain, itching, burning sensation when peeing, or sore around your vagina. If your discharge is constantly mixed with blood outside your period, or if you notice something isn't right, do well to speak with your doctor. Your body is smart. It's always giving you signals. Ignoring them can delay your treatment, but acting early can keep you safe. If you've not liked this video, please like and share the video so other women out there will get to see the video and learn from it. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and always remember, your health is your wealth. Little changes makes a big difference. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.